What is up, guys? Make sure that if you like this video, hit that like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications. What is up, guys? Fahir here, and this is just a quick tip in the MOBA game that I'm creating. I'm just gonna run the game so that you can see what I'm gonna talk about. So first here we have the character, we can move him, and now he can attack, and he has really cool attack. So if I press one of my keys that I programmed to do the attack, you will see that we have the attack and we have the sound effects as well. So let me try that again. And you see the sound effects and you see the cool effect being played out. Now, what is the tip and the trick that I'm gonna talk about? Well, you saw that these effects appear at a certain part of the animation. And for this, we use animation events. And how do we do that? Well, if I select the character who has an animator controller and component attached on him with animations, as you see here, so we have all of these animations. If I go into the animation tab, which is under window, and then you can go here, animation and animation. This is where you control the each individual animation you have. And for example, if I take here the special one attack animation. Now, if I try to preview it frame by frame, you will see the animation of my character. You see he's jumping and he's punching in the ground. And at the certain point, we want to make that effect appear. For that, we can use animation events. So for example, I choose mine to be here, exactly here when he punches the ground, then the effect appears. For that, what you need to simply do is, if I take my highlight tool, when you're at the frame, you see here I'm at this frame where I'm typing or drawing my red line. When you're at the desired frame where you want to execute a function or want to spawn that effect, you will hit this key right here. You see this one right here that I marked with the arrow and the circle. You press it and this right here will appear. So right here with the arrow that I'm pointing, this right here will appear. This is that animation event at that specific frame. What you do after that, you select that animation event. So you see I have selected it. And in the inspector panel on my right side, I can click on the drop-down list and I can, well, simply select the function I want to be executed. In here, I have selected spawn special effect 1. If I go here in my scripts, which is this one, player attack effects, this is the script. So spawn special attack effects, was it 1 or 2? I forgot. My memory is letting me out. So spawn special effect 1. This is the one that we are calling. This one right here, which is simply gonna instantiate the prefab at the desired position. Simple as that. But the point is, using these animation events, you can execute a function at a certain point of your animation. Otherwise, this would be impossible. It's really impossible to calculate this exact frame in our code. And even if we can, it will take a lot of time to, you know, be precise with the exact frame that we want. Instead of that, simply go to the desired frame where you want and then click on this button right here, which will add the animation event. From the drop-down list here, when you select that animation event, from the drop-down list on the left side, or actually on my right side in the inspector, you can select a function that you want to be executed. And voila, you can put any code that you want in that function, and voila, you are done. And while I'm here with the MOBA game, I'm just quickly gonna preview my favorite attack. So this one we have here from our angel character. This is the one that I am in love. Now pay attention now, we're gonna see a hammer fall from the sky. Now this is so cool. Now again, I'm gonna try it. Now this is the one that I really love. And just two more before I end the video. So I'm quickly gonna take the Evil King, which is another character in my game. I've been working for the past 3 days for these characters. Now this is the one that I love. He simply spawns lava at your spot and he will kill you. And the last one is meteors. Now this is really cool, the one. So these three, I cannot decide which one is better. But anyways, I was talking about keyframes. Enough about me being in love in the project that I'm working on. Fahir here, this was a short tip from me, and I will see you guys in the next video. Make sure that if you like this video, hit that like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications.